Welcome to Double Double Smackdown. After an exciting episode of Raw, we are here to see what Atile's got in store for us. Atile, how are you doing?
Pretty good.
Duel, how are you doing?
I'm alright.
Duel, your show sucked.
It kind of did, Duel.
I'm sorry.
It's okay.
You're relying too much on Hogan. When has Hogan not main evented one of your shows?
He's a top choice, making me book him.
Oh, he's got that creative control. He might jump to SmackDown.
He could. You never know. All right. Well, let's just get right into the shindigs and see what we got. If you miss the house shows, well, then you're shit out of luck. Or you can just watch Raw. Let's move on. Oh,
oh
fucking
God.
Shit.
Oh, boy.
And that's how you counter Slaughter versus Honky Tonk
Man. Fuck.
Is there no tornado tag?
Oh no!
Shit!
Can you not change the rules?
How?
Go to. Oh, I thought they had, like, custom matches.
I didn't
and
mean
shit.
To do that.
Match creator or whatever.
That was customized match. Or well, does it take me into the next thing after that?
Yeah, because you have to pick the opponents.
Okay.
If you're cus-
well, there's a customized match and customized participants.
Right. And you can't go to, like, match creator in this game?
Fucking who was
choose
it?
Choose the rules?
I don't know. Tornado's not in the game? Really?
Oh, my lord.
Oh, boy. Okay, well, I guess
make it extreme rules, then. That's Tornado.
That's a Tiles call. Is it? No, it's not.
Oh, is Tag Extreme not in this either?
No.
Oh, Fatile.
Oh, a tile. Well, I guess let's get that show on the road. The team of RVD and Colonel Mustafa finally teaming up, though. There you go.
You're letting a Raw guy on SmackDown?
Yeah, what is that about, Atile?
I'm trying to recruit him.
Oh, I see.
Recruit who, Atile?
Is it RVD?
You don't even know who I don't blame you, Atile.
That it has been ruled by Derek Kulu officially that the tag titles will be split between both brands.
Poor Booker T and Wade Barrett.
Former tag team champions.
They just lost the belt.
They lost the physical title. And
twice.
No, I think it was once, and then the NXT tag belt, then your new tag belts were given to John Cena and Kofi Kingston. And here comes the team of Colonel Mustafa and
They're
Rob Van Dam. Of course.
Wanna get high?
I don't think that's what it says. It's taking forever. Oh!
Oh, they got
they got glow sticks for the crowd!
Oh, he's getting drunk.
He's drinking beer on the job, Atile.
Atile, you let this kind of nonsense on your show?
Yep.
He's vaping like crazy.
They're treating it like it's a rave. The whole fucking show making their debut.
How'd they get any of these fucking glow sticks?
Heck of a guy is Colonel Mustafa.
Heck of a guy!
Who, if you didn't know, Atile, is on your show. Oh, boy!
Rob! Bam! Damn!
And Colonel Mustafa! He got more glow sticks!
What?
Oh.
My God, they're peddling glow sticks!
Who knows where they got Atile? I didn't know glow sticks were in the budget. And here comes the former tag team champions. They never lost the belts.
Yeah, they did.
Well, I mean, technically, they did because they misplaced them. The mystery of the stolen tag team championships is very, very interesting to me.
Yeah, but it's Five Moves of Booms titles.
They also lost them.
Why?
The physical championships of both.
He looks like he's gonna cry.
Of both teams were just lost. Hatayo, I don't know if it's you pulling some shit here or if there's a team just stealing these belts. Maybe the whole fucking show are hotting them up their ass with a bunch of glow sticks. But all I know is we no longer have SmackDown tag titles. You lost your tag belt so much that we had to give you the Raw ones.
What if those go away?
Oh, God. I'm out of fucking answers then.
And we just don't have a tag division. You lost your opportunity.
Wait. What fucking show is Booker T on? Is he on SmackDown? Okay.
Yeah.
I don't see Booker T on the roster.
The only interpromotional team is RVD and Sheiky, baby.
For some reason, Booker T isn't on, like, the roster page.
They misplaced Booker T. Look how sad he is. That was the saddest face I've ever seen.
Bad News Browns.
Whoa.
Wants it. That's their name. Once again, teaming up here on SmackDown. The irresponsible tag team that they are.
You want your belts? Well, I'm afraid I've got some bad news.
Who knows what happens to the five moves of Boom now, too?
They have to be in contention.
Yeah, that's true.
For the Samoa offs, we haven't seen in like 2 weeks.
Well, we might get a load of them at the pay-per-view.
Against which team? We really don't know.
This might decide it. Tal, you should be more careful with those things.
Just you should also never book tag matches anymore.
That's true. Hold on, I gotta do something real quick before this match begins. Let's take a quick commercial break.
Hi.
I gotta delete some stuff. Because if I don't, the recording will end and I'll look like a jerk off. There we go. Alright. Back to the action!
I'm so enthralled.
Here we go. The whole fucking show making their debut here on SmackDown. RVD, a member of the Raw roster. Duel, how do you feel about this? Did you allow him to do this? Or are you just finding out about this now?
I'm just as surprised as you are.
It's just a tile like asking a friend he's known since 1986 to come to wrestle for SmackDown.
Sorry, I shouldn't be speculating. Booker T lifts up Colonel Mustafa, the Iron Sheik, whatever you want to call him. He's been missing his friend.
Dad.
I mean, he's been missing his friend for weeks now, ever since they became a team. I don't know when they decided that.
They thought it was a good idea when they were getting high.
Oh, those pointed boots just raked across the face of Booker T. Booker T, what the? Oh! Big sidekick.
Harlem sidekick.
Is that what that is?
Yes, because Houston sidekick doesn't sound as intimidating.
Fair enough.
Bull hammer. What a weird sign.
Oh, going for the bull knee. Into the corner of RVD goes Booker T and a big backdrop.
Look at the knees of the Iron Sheik. How is he standing?
Why?
He looked fucked up.
Well, God!
Booker T! He's so angry at the Sheik.
He should be angry at RVD. RVD's not even on this show.
These two used to be a tag team.
Were they champions?
I think so.
Probably.
And then Booker T went to SmackDown and he hated SmackDown.
Come on. Oh, come on by.
He's like, SmackDown fucking sucks. I hate you, Eddie Guerrero and Undertaker.
So Bad News Barrett supposedly has never won a match. Which
Captain
I'm assuming Hunter means Booker T has also never won a match.
That sign says five time.
Colonel Mustafa also has never won a match.
Has Rob Van Dam won a match?
RVD has won a match.
Who the odds are favoring.
He's won a match. So, yes, the odds are, as far as I know, in RVD's favor. I don't have Booker T's record here, so there's that.
He's got a record.
Why you gotta bring that up?
People like him just aren't champions, all right? That's why they got the belt taken away.
Into the center of the ring goes Booker T.
What a criminal.
RVD set up for something here. Colonel Mustafa. Oh, giving him a buddy hug.
Colonel Mustafa's just so happy to be teaming.
He's so happy. He's been lonely for so long. He saw RVD hanging out with Ric Flair on Raw.
Oh yeah, what the fuck was that?
I don't know!
Are you gonna recruit Ric Flair?
Oh! Who, Hatile?
Yeah.
I guess he doesn't even know.
Oh!
Off the ropes goes Booker T, throat first.
Booker T.
Shots to the side of the head. Booker T stalking RVD. Whips
what
him around.
Says,
uh-oh. What's he set up here? Jesus!
Bomba!
Jesus! Scissor kick!
His
right
butt says Ooker.
Okay. Cover! He's not going to let his friend get pinned, though. As he breaks it up.
Oh, RVD's pissed.
As he should be. Clothesline! Another one! Ducks the line. Oh! Super kick!
One of a kind!
Booker T's up!
Barrett has yet to get into this match.
Oh, just speak of the devil!
Devil!
Tags Bad News Barrett in. Irish whip from the two. Double elbows.
That was a full hand
cover.
Elbow.
Referee just...
The referee taking his sweet-ass time.
Unsure.
He's obviously got SmackDown bias, even though the other team is being pinned.
I've just been asked if the RVD situation is similar to the Hernandez TNA situation.
Oh, fuck.
Oh.
Let's bring you a recap on the James Storm Magnus feud.
Was RVD ever actually signed to Raw?
Who knows? He just kind of wandered in.
Natal letting anything go on his show as Bad News Barrett jumps over RVD and hits a big neck breaker. Saw plenty of those on Raw. The Stretchy Man.
Oh, Stretchy Man. Oh, my goodness.
One of the most devastating...
Sheik! No, Sheik doesn't know!
Oh, no! He's trying so hard, RVD, able to power out of it, though.
He was seeing double. That's what the problem was.
They look so alike. Now he's calling for the tag. He wants his friend to tag in. What did you say? What an idiot.
Because he could have broken up that submission earlier. Now RVD's arms are all stretching.
Well, when you're flailing glow sticks around all night, you get your vision all a little impaired.
Are you sure they were flailing them or smoking them?
Oh, man.
Don't do it, Rob Van Dam!
RVD throws Barrett into their corner. Oh!
Oh, it cost him.
Fuck! Sheik did not want to see that.
RVD with a push off, he's upset.
What a nice friend the Iron Sheik is.
He just wants to prove to be a better friend than Ric Flair.
Tag, of course. I mean, RVD might just go back to Raw and stay there. What the fuck is Barrett doing? Oh!
Jesus.
Oh, God!
Oh, God, Rob Van Dam is dead.
Bare knuckle brawler.
Oh.
Punching RVD right off the apron.
Oh, Cameron Clutch.
What?
Oh, I think he's setting him up.
Well, he's trying to pull him towards the middle. He might be setting him up. He might be right here.
The camel kush.
Oh, there's rake in the back.
But he just lets him get up.
Oh!
Oh, RVD.
Giving Barrett his receipt. Oh! Barrett and RVD wanted to go at it now, but Sheik flips him over.
Amateur wrestling move by the amateur wrestler medalist.
Oh, those pointy toes. RVD might be really hurt.
Somebody, he hurt his shoulder. Or he's down.
Oh, God, what's this? Oh!
Oh, my
Jesus.
God.
Jesus! Cover!
Referee!
Two? No. RVD looked worse for wear there. Oh, with the change.
He's wiggling around on the ropes. He's kind of out of it.
Well, he's not out of enough to break up that pinfall.
I mean, he's right in front of him.
That's true. Well, so is Iron Sheik. Oh, bullhammer. I didn't see that coming at all. What the fuck?
That was not a bullhammer. That was just a punch.
Was it?
I thought he has to pull down the...
I don't know. That was fucking weird.
Weight slam!
Cover! Booker T not helping whatsoever. Devastating blow by Barrett. Oh, he's running away.
He must have heard you.
He must have. Back in the ring is Booker T firing a shot at the Iron Sheik. Reversal.
Sheiky babe Into the corner. Don't do it, Sheeta.
Corner of the whole fucking show. Went for a tag, I'd assume, but no. What's Booker going for? Oh! Sunset flip, RVD! One, two, three!
RVD's so mad at himself for just standing there.
He kicked Booker T in the head on the way back.
And the uncrowned champions win.
They are on their way to possibly getting their tag titles back.
That one wasn't as bad as the Raw tag match.
No.
Way to go, Hitao.
You see what I have next.
Oh boy!
I can't wait. Boy, those are strong words. Better deliver.
Here's how the end of the match came. RVD, it looked like he just was disappointed that Sheik was even being pinned there.
He got really confused.
And there's your winner's former... I mean, we don't even have those physical belts anymore, so technically they're still the tag champs.
Yeah, I mean, the belts don't make them the champions.
The champion doesn't make the man, Jericho. The man makes the championship. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, to make it even more confusing, both belts were called the tag team titles.
That's true.
WWE tag
titles. Well, let's not worry about that tag team titles right now as we move on to our next contest on SmackDown.
That's how I all hyped it up.
It is. Fuck!
Oh my fucking god!
It's the debuting the Guns!
I forgot about the Guns!
Here comes the Samoans!
Oh, god damn it!
Oh fuck, I forgot about the Guns!
The floodgates have been opened in the tag division! And here come the champions!
Here comes Roman Reigns! Hatao, what the fuck? What are you doing?
He wants to prove that tag team wrestling isn't dead.
I could have waited, Hatao. I wish I had waited to see what was next.
Fuck you, Hatao. You should see what I have.
Bring back Duel. There is one half of the tag team champions, Roman Reigns. Haven't seen him in a while. We thought we got rid of him.
The big dog always comes back.
Well, you've never left, Jericho.
Oh, of course. And here comes...
I shouldn't have mentioned that we hadn't seen him in a while. And here comes the other half.
Johnny!
What?
Are these two going public? Is that why they've been gone?
They could be.
They're going public!
Oh no. What could this mean?
I don't know.
That's what they say?
They're just going public.
Alright.
They're now on the stock exchange. I don't know.
Why?
The Samoans have gone public. I'm surprised.
I mean, the last time we saw them, they seemed like they were having a few issues as partners.
Yeah, they're trying to work the kinks out.
Yeah, I mean, they were able to take down the Golden Axe. Now they're here on SmackDown. Who knows what they'll do?
Oh, that's right. The tag champions for the first time on SmackDown. Yeah,
tag champions.
You just want all the Raw people on your show now.
And here comes the challengers.
Why did we name them that?
Because they're Guns! I have a theme song for them, too.
Really?
Yeah. And here they come, the debuting Cunts.
God damn it.
Even with just debuting, they're the most hated team in the universe.
They're a bunch of Cunts.
What a bunch of cunts.
They seem happy.
I mean, when you're a cunt and everyone hates you, You really don't have many options.
Fair.
A title bringing all the new teams to fruition here. They actually already had a Titantron before they debuted. There it is. That's how I got the song. But let's get right into the action. Tag Team Champions, the Samoas, taking on the Cunts.
Oh!
Reverse RKO, starting off the match.
I don't want to call this match because I feel dirty. Dirty cunts. They're not just heels. They're dirty heels. They're dirty cunts. Are they heels?
Yes.
All right.
The Samoas are the good guys.
Clearly. I mean, they just did go public.
Of course. Seth Rollins not even wearing Shield attire. He's got his cunt gear on.
Of course, only a cunt would wear that. That's why Roman Reigns is almost wearing it.
Hatal, how could you let such a name be put on TV?
Because in Canada, it's not as bad.
Oh. These guys are firing shots at each other.
What a cunt.
And a big backbreaker by Randy Orton.
Dolph Ziggler looks so interested.
I mean, this is the first time he's teamed with Roman Reigns in quite some time. Let's see, when was the last time they teamed? Let's see. Wasn't that one?
Oh, beautiful dropkick from the rookie.
They teamed on episode 3 of Raw.
Oh.
And they lost. And then episode 4, they lost as well.
They've been having some issues.
But they wanted I believe they wanted payback. Because they're still champs, so.
Not truly. They win when it matters.
Oh, God,
Samoas drop!
Jesus! He's really happy about it. Oh!
God.
Right to the mouth!
Right to that cunt.
Oh, my God!
That would have been over.
Almost a 3 count, but that cunt Randy Orton able to get up! Spear!
Oh!
Roman Reigns!
Spear!
1, 2... Oh, what a cunt breaking that up.
Yeah, look how angry he looks.
Reverse suplex by Roman Reigns.
There comes the show off. Dolph Ziggler. Very athletic.
Kicked him in the ass. Bunch of shots to the head. How about you do some play-by-play, Jericho? Let's see what you got.
Well, he's going for the cover here. Like a cunt, the ref just stops the count.
He's not a part of that team.
Now, what do you think the phrase "over it" means on his butt?
No!
Is that a
No! What a cunt! You fucking cunt, Randy Orton! You cunt!
My God, I've never seen such a move.
Fuck you!
Johnny is not happy with that. But yeah, like a subtle shot at Roman Reigns by putting "over it" on his butt. Like, he's over
so
there.
So angry
squabble.
Right now. I hate this team.
Are they a bunch of cunts?
Absolutely.
Okay. What a cunt.
Dolph Ziggler. Fuck! Weight slam!
Big dog slam!
Oh, he's talking. I think that was a shot at the former tag champs, Jericho.
Oh, maybe.
They want to prove they're the real tag champs. Another one!
Again! Double weights!
I mean, the problem between the two before Jericho. Oh! Superman punch! Fuck what I'm saying! Cover! 1, 2, no!
Seth
the problem
Rollins
with him before Jericho is
he's in this match.
Dolph Ziggler did feel like Roman Reigns was trying to show off, really. Uh-oh. Setting
Wrong
him up. Oh, God! Cuts him in half!
Slice that cunt up.
What?
Yeah, I said it.
Dolph Ziggler in the ring. Oh! Into the corner of the Samoas goes Randy Orton. Referee in the way. Oh, he's smothering him. Oh. You were supposed to be commentating. What the fuck?
And now he says that's enough. Apparently. Oh, he apologizes.
Oh, what a move by Dolph Ziggler.
Cover.
For that, here's a cover to pin.
Referee way out of position.
Suck my thigh.
No.
Oh. Cheeseburger.
Uh-oh.
That could be it.
Not gonna call it? Okay. Two. No.
Oh. Randy Orton getting effed in the A. Seth Rollins hasn't even been tagged in the goddamn match.
We're trying to keep Randy Orton in the ring. Beat that cunt.
Here comes the frequent tags of the Samoas.
That's why they're the champs.
It's the heel team that needs the hot tag.
It's too hot. Hot tag. Stretchy man.
He's saying yes.
I don't know what... What the fuck? What is Randy Orton doing?
What the...
Oh! Holy shit!
Why?
Why, Orton? What the hell are you doing? What a cunt!
No kidding. This is just breaking down.
I'm not sure what's happening or why he just did that. Alright. Orton's hurt, though. Something happened there. I think he's trying to... Oh, Roman Reigns!
Roman Reigns doesn't know who to attack!
He is confused.
Into the ropes. Alright. What a cunt. Oh! That just pissed him off.
Orton's fired up! Oh!
Superman punch, I love it.
Damn it.
Tatar, why did you book two tag matches?
Uh-oh, he's in the corner.
Ooh, He's got a walk towards it.
The most intimidating spear setup I've ever seen. Uh-oh, he might be setting Seth Rollins up. Seth Rollins finally in the match.
Orton is tired out.
Oh, I mean, he's been in the match from the beginning. Samoas. A real team. Uh-oh.
You said the cunts aren't a real team.
Oh. They're pieces of shit. Uh-oh.
Wait, slam.
Jesus. Dolph wants that tag, Jericho.
He doesn't want Roman Reigns to show off.
Oh.
Right to the abs.
He's a very well-toned man, Jericho.
Well, he does that CrossFit shit.
Hatal, do you do CrossFit?
Not anymore.
Oh, boomer, yay!
Yow!
I saw the kind of cunts that do it, and I decided I didn't want to do it anymore.
Rent. Fuck!
Overdrive! Accelerate!
Son of a... I hate this fucking team.
It's gotta be it.
If he would have won there... Roman Reigns... Oh, KO!
Oh, out of nowhere! He doesn't even try to stop Ziggler.
Oh, stomp to the head. Why would you ever kick a man in the head if you're Randy Orton? Roman
what
Reigns
is Roman Reigns doing?
He's out of it, man.
He's so overdriven.
He's over it. Why did he no-sell that? Lifting him back up.
Orton is out. This is your chance to win. Oh!
He's not that out, though. Back up. It's... Oh!
He literally, like, turned him around and speared him in half.
Roman Reigns controlling this matchup. He's showing off if I've ever seen it, Jericho.
That's what this match is all about. Now that they've gone public, they gotta play nice, but there's still those subtle shots at each other.
Well, if they win here, I believe their stock would rise even more.
Well, I mean, they're the champions. How can they possibly get higher?
Well, if they were the whole faction
show.
The fans
are going nuts right now.
Roman, I think he's a little too dazed for this. He's tagging out. Seth cuts him off before he has a chance to do anything. Into the corner of the cunts goes Dolph Ziggler.
Oh my god, he's stuck with
uh-oh!
Buckle bomb!
Jesus!
Oh! Well,
cover!
Give him a concussion!
Roman's not even getting in! Oh!
He has faith, or is being really passive-aggressive. Because if Ziggler takes the pin, then he can complain about it.
TNA kick! What the fuck?
That didn't look right.
Oh! Sweep the leg, Johnny!
But his name is Colby.
Carino?
Colby.
Tags in Randy Orton.
What a cunt. Can we see another overdrive?
Hopefully not. Oh, God!
Oh! That could be it. Seth Rollins is tired out. Seth Rollins is tired. Oh, God damn it!
What a cunt. Lifts Orton up. Throws him out of the ring.
Oh, fuck.
I don't know what the plan is here. This crowd is loud as shit, though. What the fuck happened there?
Only on SmackDown.
Randy Orton has some trouble. Oh!
Oh! This could be it. What is happening?
They want to take it to the streets. Oh.
What a cunt.
Point of the elbow to the jaw of Dolph Ziggler. Into the ring they go. Where Orton goes. Rolls him over.
Oh my god. Okay. What a cunt. Teasing that he was going to pin him.
Oh. What an uppercut. Uppercut. Tags out to Seth Rollins. Oh! Seth Walker!
Oh, cunt Walker!
One! Two! Oh!
Roman Reigns, the big talk's not
gonna
let it end like
god
that.
Damn it. Oh, here you go. Good fucking timing, Orton. Oh, shit! Oh.
Look out! Oh, okay, good.
Banned.
That person is wearing a Kofi Kingston shirt and a John Cena hat.
Whoa. Trying to sweep the leg. Sleeper hold.
He's going to put that gun to sleep.
Can Orton get there in time? Oh! He taps!
What a... He's attacking him after.
Why did Orton stomp on Seth's head?
The Samoans have gone public and they are still the best team.
Oh, what a shot. There it is. Tag team champions showing their dominance.
Oh, let's just show Roman Reigns getting all the
he's
big spots.
So strong.
Overdrive.
We didn't see that. Fuck you. And here's the end of the match. Dolph Ziggler able to put Seth Rollins to sleep. Randy Orton was already sleeping.
He was like, what's going on? Boom.
He stomps on Seth Rollins to try to wake him up. What the
fuck? Okay. Seth Rollins wasn't even there.
Here's that tag scene that everyone does.
I bet somebody's going out there.
Are they going to shake hands? Ah!
Go to that corner.
Meet me on the top rope.
They have gone public, ladies and gentlemen. The So-Mo-offs.
So-Mo.
Or even more than that.
What friends?
They're the Republic of Samoa.
Well, that was only our second match of the night, Jericho. Who knows what we have?
Oh, God, I hope we have a singles match next to Tal.
What does Tal have in store for us next?
Oh, God, I hope it's Fandango and JBL, the greatest feud in America.
Oh!
Yes!
You ask and you shall receive. Tal is a giving man.
My God, the dancing machine is about to take on Jibble.
Here comes John Bradshaw Layfield, a man known, not really known for his dancing, but he can bust a move from time to time.
Won their match last week.
I believe, did JBL win last week? Let's see. JBL, yeah, he won. It was a submission match.
Oh, man. How do you make a robot submit? A dancing machine.
Fandango had dedicated the match to his master, who he then shortly after found out was Bray Wyatt as he hit the Sister Abigail on JBL.
That happened?
Yeah.
I don't remember that.
I don't know why he had the Sister Abigail as a finisher, but he had it. And it just so happens that they were already in the stable, so fuck it.
It's raining money.
He is the Rainmaker, though.
Rain Maggle.
The Rain Maggle.
This is match number 3 on SmackDown.
He did it before. He's planning on doing it again, this time by pinfall.
These are all ones that JBL throws at strippers, so they'll dance for him. So maybe he's here to make Fandango dance.
Ooh.
Look at that face. And here comes the one they call the Dancing Machine.
Are you ready?
Oh, Jesus.
Now.
And here comes the one that created this dancing machine, Summer Rae.
I am Summer Rae.
Sounds a lot like Fandango.
Shut up.
And here comes the dancing machine. Oh, what the fuck? The dancing machine Fandango.
Oh, okay.
We won't talk about it.
All right.
Making his way to the ring. He's been on a war path ever since debuting. He was one match away from winning the King of the Ring, as we've noted before. He's very oily.
As he should be.
As he should be.
He is a machine.
Oh, look at that dancing. That dancing nameplate.
Da 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 da. That's what it says on his Titantron. Maybe he's just
that.
Looking for his dad.
The crowd is ones and zeroing.
Why is Layla all over his Titantron?
He's a machine. Da, da, da. It's a catchy tune, though.
Number one on the UK charts.
He's big name in the UK.
And how do you say that name?
It's Fandango.
Fandango.
Well, maybe after the match he'll tell us how to say it. If we're lucky.
If he wins.
Maybe he should just tell us right now.
He's too busy getting groped by Summer Rae. And there's his portrait to his master. That doesn't look like Bray Wyatt.
That doesn't look
at all.
Anything like Bray Wyatt.
That looks like Disco Inferno.
Well, here we go.
I'm a little caught off guard with this one, to be honest.
Me too, Jericho. JBL starting to match off with a gut buster. Things don't always look as they seem, Jericho, as JBL drops an elbow.
No kidding!
Oh, he went for it. I think he was going for the clothesline from hell there, Jericho.
Already.
Suplex into the corner. Punching away at the skull of John Bradshaw Lethal. Hey, my name's John. Hey, your name's Fandango. Oh, no, it's not.
No.
And they're squaring. Wait.
Oh, yeah.
Wait
he
a second.
He doesn't even want to.
What? What's he doing?
He doesn't want to get. Okay, maybe he does.
What the fuck? Wait,
now
he's walking
here.
Out! Where's
he's
he
walking out.
Where's he going? Fandango leaving in the middle of this match! Not even the middle!
Shit.
What? He's gonna dance up there! Oh, he's coming back!
He's redoing his entrance!
Fandango back in the ring! Oh, God!
Boy, the AI in this game, not very good!
He's malfunctioning, Jericho! That's all that's happening there!
All right. It was a trick, clearly.
I mean, he's not perfectly programmed. Now he's pounding away at JBL.
That submission match last week must have fucked with his wiring.
Maybe. Irish, what the fuck was that?
That was the great storyline, making in universe mode.
I see. JBL gets belly to bellied into the ropes. Cover. No, not no count. Back on his feet is JBL. Big shot to the head. And no.
Oh, knee to the circuit breaker.
Oh, knee to the Domsky.
Those knees must be loaded.
He's no Edge.
Well, yeah.
Into
he's
the,
JBL.
Oh, God. What an Irish whip. Who booted up Fandango in safety dance mode? Oh! Big
right
Inzi.
To the back of the head.
Big Inzi.
Enzi Amore. Oh, why isn't he doing Enzigiri for a finisher?
Why?
Oh, the Enzo Giri.
That sounded better in your head, didn't it?
Yeah.
Enzigiri. Oh, God.
Beauty shot.
The bionic legs of Fandango just smashing into the head of JBL. Oh, my God.
Okay.
JBL's on fire, though. Sends Fandango into the corner.
And stops.
And turns him around.
What's the look of those abs?
Where's JBL going? Up top. Oh, God.
What the
Cena sent down. Ducks a lot, JBL.
Oh, my God.
Jesus Christ. JBL.
JBL's a wrestling machine.
Holy shit. Neckbreaker. That could be it. One, two, no. What the fuck? Oh, God, JBL. He's going to put a cigar out.
Boy.
Oh, no, he's not, I guess. Power bomb! Fuck!
Oh, God, with impact.
That's it. One, two, three.
Poor machine. He just keeps getting beaten and battered. He needs an upgrade.
Here we go. Replays from this matchup. Maybe will we see Fandango leaving? I guess not. There's the bionic legs to the head of JBL.
That looked like a three.
Here's the big neck breaker. Oh, God, I'm malfunctioning. Almost put Fandango away there.
Well, it took one more move. Look at that impact. Just bam, right on his back.
Lifts
no
him up.
No give.
Tosses it down like he's a piece of shit.
He's a piece of metal.
And there you have it, your winner, John Bradshaw Layfield. Maggle.
Well, he deserved the win after Fandango ran away like a pussy.
Oh, he's just staring at him. Oh, he's
not a Nazi salute.
He spit on him. What? I don't think this is the last we've seen of Fandango and JBL going against each other. Look at that
Fandango's
ass.
Fandango's got to do something, though, to really get the edge in the next time they meet up.
He's got to get bees, maybe?
He's got to get some sort of upgrade. Summer Rae's going to have to work on him.
Let's move on to our next matchup here. On SmackDown, Natal. What a crazy show this has been. Oh!
God, this isn't the main event.
No, it's not.
Oh, what?
The champ is here.
Cesaro squashed the Intercontinental Champion in the last show.
Cesaro's the new star around here. It's a little fucking belt.
That's just a big man.
Corey Graves and Brock Lesnar have had possibly the most heated rivalry in the history of the universe. Back and forth.
History of the universe.
In the history of the universe. No pyro needed there.
But we're going to cut the camera anyway.
Back and forth. These men have gone each and every week. Last week, Corey Graves was able to defeat Brock Lesnar, if I'm remembering correctly. Which I might not be.
At this point, does it really matter?
Nope, I was right. And here comes the man they call Mr. Irrelevant.
Corey Graves.
Somehow able to stay in this fucking world title picture.
They want him to go back to his Stardust gimmick. But he's like, no. I'm Corey Graves now.
Money in the Bank, he will have one more opportunity to win back the World Heavyweight Championship.
And they never have to wrestle again.
Thank God.
Remember their last match when Brock Lesnar just beat the fuck out of him.
He did. I don't know what happened last week, though. I'm not really sure what happened. Corey Graves
all I know is that
just beat him.
He triggered some of his concussion symptoms.
Oh, triggered.
He got triggered. He shouldn't be competing, but Hatayo is making this man compete with Brock Lesnar.
I mean, Duel doesn't seem to care about Santino's well-being, so I guess Hatayo's following suit.
But this man literally was told he can't wrestle. Santino's at least trying to make a comeback. Stay down. Stay down, Corey Graves.
Well, if he doesn't beat Brock at Money in the Bank, he's going to have to stay down. The card, that is.
Back to our relevancy.
And here we go. It's time for Brock Lesnar to take on Corey Graves. Oh, Corey's starting off hot!
He wants to get that submission win.
Attacking the legs of Brock Lesnar. Drops the elbow.
That's where Lesnar's weakest, because he always skips leg day.
Does he?
Look at you, ever see how skinny his legs
are? Those are pretty skinny legs. Brock's
what a big man.
Look at the ease with picking up Corey Graves. Oh, MMA punches.
You have to think that
no,
the
I
war
don't.
These two are going to go at Money in the Bank, the Money in the Bank winner could be looking at them as well.
They could be.
We were talking about Hogan and Batista, but this is also a world title feud.
That's true, it is.
It's been going on for a long time.
The longest feud in the history of the universe. Oh!
Suplex City, Philadelphia, even though we're not in Philly
concussion
anymore.
Concussion City.
Concussion City, bitch.
What the fuck?
Whoa. He's got telepathy now from all those concussions.
What a reverse. Oh, God. No, Brock.
Brock, please.
Hatal, how can you let this happen?
What do you got against Corey Graves?
We understand that you only book Corey Graves because you want to see him get beat up, but isn't this a little much?
It's never too much.
God damn.
Boy, you're the sadistic son of a bitch, Hatal. What a cunt.
Brock with a reversal kick to the luchador tattooed stomach. Oh, God. Fuck.
And his foot is on the rope and he won't break.
But that's that veteran instinct. Into the corner goes Brock Lesnar. Oh, fuck. Graves stomping on that arm, the elbow of Brock Lesnar.
He's got to do something here. Or he's going to get another concussion.
Should start suplexing Brock. Oh, jawbreaker!
Oh! He's going to give him a Sterling Games concussion. Wait
what
a minute.
The fuck? Brock easily swept off his feet because of those little chicken
those
legs.
Little chicken legs.
What is Corey Graves doing? He better not do the NL special. That's banned.
He doesn't follow the rules.
Oh.
Don't do it, Lesnar. No more suplexes.
Corey Graves with an Irish whip. Is he Irish? Who knows?
He's gonna be.
Going for a body slam. No, Corey lifts the big man up, backbreaker.
And now Brock Lesnar's up and he's angry.
What was that disease Lesnar had?
Diverticulitis.
Ah. Yeah.
You know, the thing that Triple H worked over in their SummerSlam
match. Oh, yeah. He worked over his diverticulitis?
Yes. And Michael Cole was like, remember! Remember! Remember what happened to Lesnar! Remember that stomach issues!
Oh! Stop punching the man in the head! I don't like Corey Graves as much as the next guy, but oh, God!
Stay down! Oh, on the back of the neck!
He's up!
Oh, the fighting spirit!
Corey Graves
so strong.
Will not stay down! Ducks the line!
Power slam!
Jesus! Uh-oh. What the? Where's he going? Hey!
Oh, whoa!
Come on, what did we do to you? Don't worry about us! He's going crazy! His head's all fucked up and he doesn't know what he's doing!
It allowed Brock Lesnar time to get up!
Oh god, he's got him up! What the hell is this? Weight slam!
Oh! Weight slam mark two!
Oh god, one! Two!
Oh! Lesnar, he's not gonna kick up to that.
The fade
even
to a relevancy.
Last week he's dropped to a simple move as well.
The fade to a relevancy. Oh god, Brock! Oh no. He can't handle this! No!
Oh, not one! Not two!
Oh my god. Cover! I wouldn't be surprised if this is in here, Jericho. Oh!
Oh, I'm surprised!
I'm very surprised that it's not!
Oh my god.
Uh-oh. Brock's calling for it.
Let me see, the F5.
Oh, he's got him up! No, Corey Graves!
Corey Graves! This is your opportunity
far
to win
back.
That title.
Oh! Jesus! Brock's up!
Stay down!
Forearm shot! Big clothesline, no! Forearm shot!
We're getting shooty here.
Oh!
Oh! Busts him open! Lesnar doesn't like getting hit in the face.
He's picking him up. Fade to irrelevancy!
Oh my
Jesus.
God! Oh, what a move!
Center of the ring, Corey Graves! One, two, no!
Lesnar's such fighting spirit.
Holy shit!
How do you fight back from that move?
Oh, God!
Oh, that shouldn't be legal.
Taste of his own medicine there. Oh, God. Lifts Corey up. Big backbreaker.
This is our chance, Brock. Hit the shooting star press.
He's gonna beat him to death instead.
Oh, God. Too bad we have no KOs.
Corey Graves reverses. Big clothesline.
What the fuck was that?
I think that was a clothesline.
He's kind of hugged him.
Oh! A man like Corey Graves after... Oh my god, cover! One! No, that's not going to put away Brock fucking Lesnar. It was. Oh! Right in his diverticulitis.
Oh, no!
Big shots by Corey Graves. Uh-oh. He's wakening the beast! Jesus!
Oh, beast for business.
Pounding his head in again.
Enough is enough. If this is what they do on SmackDown, imagine what's gonna happen at Money in the Bank!
Oh, fucking hell! Brock, stop! What will it take? That might be it. Brock's just beating the shit out of him. He might be knocked out. One, two, no!
Jesus.
Corey Graves.
The crowd is going insane.
He's already dead, Brock. Oh, what's this?
Oh, he's fucking him.
Oh, kicked out. What? Brock got desperate there. I've never seen that before.
Corey Graves.
He's choking.
That's not legal.
Fade to irrelevancy!
Oh, so irrelevant.
Right on the diverticulitis! That has to be it. One, two, three!
Corey Graves continues to prove why he's the number one contender.
If Corey Graves can pull off a performance like that at Money in the Bank, he will absolutely get his championship back.
He's now up two. Brock Lesnar's got to do something here.
He's got to upgrade.
He's doing everything he can, but Corey Graves always kicks out.
We didn't see one F5 in that match, though, Jericho. It was one attempted.
He tried, and that's really what might have cost him.
It
took like seven moves to get him back.
Fade to irrelevancy.
Yeah, we're not even done with this show.
No, we got one more match coming up. And there is your winner.
Oh, boy.
Corey Graves.
We might have to take a break.
We might have to. He won't stay down, Jericho.
It amazes me.
But you can see he's worn out. Brock Lesnar leaving with blood all over his face.
Glory Graves going to become a two-time heavyweight champion of the world. Yes, we know. Stay down.
Hatile's plan is backfiring here.
Maybe Hatile is Corey Graves.
Oh, shit.
We didn't hear Hatile talk at all.
Well, here we go. The main event of the evening. Of course.
Oh, my God. Mark Henry got literally no offense in their last encounter.
I guess Hatile wants to give Mark Henry another chance. I mean, he is a champion.
Is he?
He's the Intercontinental... Is he not the Intercontinental champion?
I'm saying that was an embarrassing showing last week.
Well, yeah.
He looks pissed.
I would be pissed, too.
Cesaro just made him his bitch.
Maybe tonight he will beat him up and break his neck.
Maybe.
Look at that belt extender.
That's mean. Don't point that out.
Why will we retire? Like Alex Kozlov?
Well, we don't talk about that in front of me. We don't talk about Alex Kozlov. You wanna know who's not fat?
Who?
The man coming out next. Cesaro! Oh boy. He better hurry up.
Yeah, well, yeah. Mark Henry, 1-1 in Universe competition. And Cesaro undefeated here.
The crowd
on SmackDown.
Is going nuts.
After last week's showing, I'd be fucking going crazy for him too. The man completely dominated Mark Henry in a way that we've never seen before. Corey Graves can't even get manhandled by Brock Lesnar in that way.
Was he not introduced to the ring?
Everyone knows who he is after last week, Jericho.
Is Justin Roberts asleep?
Why did he not intro?
Is this game is broken as shit. Why are you here, Justin Roberts?
You didn't do anything, Justin Roberts. You can't do that, Cesaro.
Antonio Cesaro.
And we will come back with our main event matchup right after these words.
After these messages.
SmackDown rolls on after this. Too hot.
Did you turn off commentary?
Yes.
Maybe that's why.
But did he not intro Mark Henry?
I don't know.
Why would those be connected? That's stupid. This is a Saturday Night's Main Event commercial, yeah. Alright. And we're back!
I wonder if Mark Henry will get an offensive hit in.
Well, let's see. Here we go. Oh! Cesaro! Oh, Jesus! Cesaro starting off with a dominant
shot. Wait a minute!
Oh!
There we go, he hugged him!
There it is.
Mark Henry's not gonna let that happen twice.
Not 2 weeks in a row, no.
These two are going to be squaring off, I believe, at Money in the Bank.
If Hatile didn't give Cesaro a title shot now after that, he better give him one at the pay-per-view. Cesaro, oh god, can he lift a big man? Oh god!
The power of the King of Swing!
Santino's not in this match.
Or the Swiss
Holy
man.
Holy shit!
Oh, the power of the world's strongest man.
Mark Henry showing why he is the Intercontinental Champion by throwing Cesaro in the air.
Cesaro!
Wow.
Who is
Antonio.
The real strongest man on SmackDown?
Harsh whip by Cesaro brings it back. Oh, Mark Henry with a kick to the gut. Mark Henry just moving a little too slow here.
Well, at least he's getting something, as like his last match, he didn't do a goddamn thing. Uh-oh.
Nope.
I got a bunch of lag.
Do you?
It says the quality is low.
Oh.
Boy, the PlayStation 4, not happy with this match. What do you have to say about that, Tao? The crowd is just sitting on their fucking... That last match exhausted them.
Did it? You don't say. Divorce court by Cesaro. Cesaro, big double stomp once again. Do you have Cesaro going in this one, Jericho?
Of course, after last week. That's why the fans don't give a shit. They know Cesaro's going to win.
Michinoku driver.
Look at the power.
The power.
Cesaro might be the strongest white man in this match.
Antonio.
Look at the power. What happened? Okay.
What?
That was strange.
What, that pinfall?
He kind of like hopped out of it and then just sat there.
Oh, shit!
Oh, right on the face.
Uppercuts.
Now, what is working the knee do? I know he's not wearing knee pads.
Well, I mean, if you take out his legs, Jericho, it'll make it hard for you to pick up the big man. Oh.
Fair.
Shot to the face. What the fuck? Punch that face again.
These two are already exhausted and trading blows. It's been like a minute. Oh!
What the fuck?
Okay! He's a big dog!
Oh my god! So close! Oh god, big uppercut!
Well, when you're desperate, what do? You hit an uppercut.
You drop Mark Henry on his shoulder is what you do. Hatal, is your feet okay?
It's doing all right.
All right. Just making sure.
Oh, your feet hurt.
What the hell?
What the hell?
Headbutt. And I'll throw him like a piece of shit.
That wasn't really a methodical move there, just pure power.
Uh-oh, I think that was an attempted world's strongest slam. Holy shit!
Right into the ropes. This one has to be over.
One, two, no!
Oh, Cesaro. He's got to pull something else out. Perhaps a neutralizer. An izer that is not in any direction.
Him being able to throw Mark Henry just clean into the air. What the fuck? Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
Jericho, this isn't looking good for Cesaro.
The world's strongest slam coming up.
Oh, God. Oh. It's very close to the ropes, though. Not enough to get a rope break, I guess. That's it.
And that's why Mark Henry is the Intercontinental Champion of the Intercontinents.
There's that weird fucking pin.
And that thing... That almost ended the match.
I would have called that as a rope break as well, but the fans not happy about that when they wanted Cesaro to win.
Oh, look at that. He almost knocked out of the ring.
Here's the end of the match. Big world's strongest slam.
What a main event, Hatile. What would you rate that?
What a show. I'd give that one coat.
Oh! You're like, get the fuck away from me. Sorry.
Why is he so mean?
Because he was embarrassed last week, and now he proves why he is your Intercontinental Champion. He's made like three times as many appearances as Sting has. Poor Sting.
He costs a lot of money, alright?
Yeah.
Woo! We will see you at Saturday Night's main event.
Oh my god, it's gonna be a big one too.
It's a
you
big
know
one.
Why?
Why?
Because we're gonna find out who the NXT champion is.
Oh shit!
That's right. The biggest non-show title one could win.
By god.
The being NXT champion means you're the future.
Who is the future of the WWE? We have one unread news.
Oh shit.
Frustration is building between Rivals JBL and Fandango.
Yeah, I'm a little frustrated by that match, too, to
yeah,
be honest.
Me too, Jericho. Let's
Let's black out the screen and see what.
Let's head on over to Saturday Night's main event.
Oh, let's see how the show's been. Oh, of course!
House show loop tradition.
Christian and Luger.
Can I read the results?
Oh, well, it really doesn't matter who wins, but Luger won. Oh, and the U.S. title holder Adnan going against Adam Rose. No longer hot, but Adam Rose beats the United States champion. And then Slaughter and Regal. Neither man is American. And Regal wins. Oh, yeah, there we go. We're bringing it to TV.
That's about right.
And Hogan wins again. And this one, too. Because, you know, we don't want to change things up. That'd be too hard.
I would keep this one all the time.
This one should have been the title match.
And our main event for the NXT Championship. Oh!
Oh, my God.
Sting wants another belt.
Oh, the filthy animals might get a belt back. Oh,
Ultimate Warrior never lost his. I should have changed it and made that a title match. Yeah, fuck it, whatever.
I guess we could afford Sting for this one. As NBC is paying half.
Of course.
The United States champion with a rare appearance.
To get another belt. Not even to defend his belt.
It's for the NXT title. Who's the future?
Who is that? Gotta load in all those.
Daniel Bryan, I hope he's okay. The last time we saw him, he was acting a little strange.
A little bit. And here he comes. One third of the filthy animals.
He's very confused. Fans are saying yes, but he is not.
Is this a SmackDown main event or Raw?
Raw. It says the United States champion in it.
Wait, oh yeah, that's right.
Cool. You finally get a main event on main event.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Even though the filthy animals won all the belts, so you always get them.
Well, will a third filthy animal win in a main event?
I mean, Hogan is the Brahma Bowl champion. We need to go fix that.
I gave him that.
Okay, good. So they lost that. They still have the smoking skull on Batista.
Right.
Or no,
right.
On Warrior.
Yeah.
And now the filthy animals could be the future.
They could be the future. That might be good for the future of Batista. Because if Daniel Bryan's the future and the filthy animals are the future, that would mean Batista's a future world champion.
Exactly. But he's got to get past the United States champion. Yes, you
got to get past the United States. You got to get past the United States to get to the future. Oh, boy.
From the other side of darkness.
From the other side of the tracks.
A man
the
called
crew.
Steve.
Oh. There he is. Put the belt over his jacket.
What a gun.
He looks not happy to be here.
I mean, how arrogant that he would change it to the old WCW one. He just can't get over it.
Leave the memories alone, Sting. Fucking a lot of pyro for this show.
He's like, I agree.
Kevin Nash levels of pyro. The man they call Sting. That guy loves WWE. Oh, shit.
Justin Roberts, you are going down.
Why is he out here? He never introduces anybody.
You'd think that maybe Daniel Bryan would be getting a future shot at the U.S. title if he can win this one.
You would think so.
But who knows, because we never see Sting on Raw. He just does what he wants.
He's too good for Raw.
Remember, the NXT title on the line.
NXT championship on the line. It's Daniel Bryan representing the Filthy Animals and Sting representing WCW.
I'm very confused. I thought Sting had both U.S. titles.
Well, it fucking took one away, remember?
But it took the wrong one away.
No, we wanted them to have that one.
He
I think that's the no, that's the one on Raw.
Yeah.
I get what you're saying.
I guess he just threw the other one in the garbage.
Oh! Enzo Aguirre, right, Jericho?
Yeah, that's a good one.
Uh-oh. Surfboard stretch. Oh, never mind. Oh!
It was Enzo Aguirre.
Right.
Not Enzo Aguirre. What are you,
well, that's dummy? That's what you said.
Enzo Aguirre. That man is leaving.
Jawbreaker.
These people are leaving.
Everyone always leaves this show. Oh, the weird Cesaro move.
Daniel Bryan. He's typing really fast.
Hey. Gotta. Oh! That might have been a knee.
The running knee. The running arm. That guy is asleep in the Kiss shirt.
Kiss shirt?
He's leaned back.
What Kiss shirt?
Oh, never. He's leaning forward again. He was like leaned back, staring at the ceiling. Nobody's paying attention.
They don't care about the future. They want now. They want the U.S. champion to win.
The future is now.
That doesn't make any sense. Over the top.
Says in the NXT intro.
Daniel Bryan, big suplex to the inside, pulling Sting back in the ring. Sting of the ring.
Sting of the ring.
Oh!
Oh, how did that hit?
He jumped over his Enzo Aguirre and hit him with a dropkick. Big shot by Daniel Bryan. If this match happened today, it'd be kind of crazy.
But sadly,
Jericho's
one man
move.
Is broken down and almost retired.
And the other is
the
Sting.
The other is Sting.
We might see Sting at SummerSlam if he keeps his belt, and in real life too. Arm drag! Oh.
I should go there then. It's in New York.
Is it?
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Brooklyn.
Brooklyn, Brooklyn.
He's just trying to gag him.
Gag him.
I don't like Daniel Bryan.
Okay. Well, I guess we can work through this.
Protection.
We can work through this. Maybe that's what Warrior's teaching him. Warrior's
protection?
A big Christianity guy, ain't he?
Christianity's abstinence. They don't believe in sex education.
Yeah, but if you're going to do it, better wrap your willy.
Yeah, Daniel Bryan.
No, he's saying no. I will not wrap my willy.
Look what happened to Nikki Bella.
Oh, God, Sting's...
Oh, it's Wolfpack Sting.
Wolfpack Sting is here. He is it. That's a member of the NWO, Jericho.
Oh, my God.
Is he donning the colors to join Hollywood?
Ow. Wolfpack's back.
Oh, God.
It's
a ballerina. One. No. Sting's frustrated. Fuck. Fuck.
Office for the NXT title.
It's a. They want to be the future.
I think Sting just wants to get booked.
He could just ask. Ask Duel.
Duel.
Duel, why don't you book Sting?
I don't want to.
But he's one of your champions.
Fair enough.
Well, I guess so.
This match isn't working. My cat fell asleep.
One.
The fans and every animal around are falling asleep.
Duel hates the U.S. title.
What's that?
The duel hates the U.S. title.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Oh, I get it.
I see that now. Stinger Splash, by the way.
Remember when we were always trying to do the Stinger Splash and couldn't do it?
You mean you?
You remember when we were all trying to do the Stinger Splash?
I don't remember. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. No, I remember now. Yeah, yeah. Jesus!
If only he was the man called Steve. That legitimately creeped Johnny out.
That was really weird.
We should go back and play that version.
Into the ring goes Sting again. Stomp to the back of the knee, or at least an attempted stomp to the back of the knee. Uh-oh! Cock!
Blocked. Oh, you should have wrapped your willy!
He hurt himself there. He's got the rope. Uh-oh. Forearm. Holy shit! Cover!
Daniel no.
Bryan. What? What are you saying, Jericho?
Daniel Bryan with the warrior lock!
Oh, God! Oh, it's it!
The future is now! You were right at the ropes, you asshole!
The filthy animals get another- Look at all the signs!
Holy shit!
The fuck? The filthy animals gain a belt after just losing one. Daniel Bryan just made the United States Champion tap out.
I'm sure Batista will get another shot at that probable title.
After the Stinger Splash, Sting tried to pick up the win, bloody and all. But it was not this move that did it. But
no,
this
it wasn't.
One.
Sting was right there. He just probably wanted to leave.
Look at those tassels.
Oh, they're on his face.
Oh, that just, I didn't see this. He was choking him with his tassel.
You're going to let a man like this be NXT champion duel. Wait a minute.
What the?
Oh, my God. Go to bed. Go to bed.
He wants him all to go to bed. It's way past their bedtime. Oh, no. Well, that's it for Saturday night's main event.
You know what? CM Punk is the NXT champion.
Oh, my God.
CM Punk is the new NXT
He's
champion.
He's the future. Go to bed. Saturday night's main event is over. That damn Punk.
The future has a curfew.
Oh, fuck.